down here to a local park called 5313. Got a lot of mud. We're gonna try the king quad out here today and just play around a little. Junk cars laying everywhere. Got a bunch of mud here, that's for sure. Now, some of y'all may not know, these snorkels on my King Quad are just for the CVT transmission. The factory air intake is still right here. So, I don't try to drown it like a submarine, but I do play in the mud with it. That way, if any of y'all was wondering, that's my cousin over on his 750, one of my buddies on an old 300 Honda. Actually re-geared this thing, boys, down with some 16 gram rollers, secondary spring, and a 1.5 millimeter shim. It used to not wheelie like that in the water, so I'm kind of excited about that. It ain't even tire deep yet. I'll winch you up if you get stuck. You got it low? You got the diff lock? Yeah, boy, it's going. And pull it. Pretty good little mud hole there. Kenda Executioners. Oh, it does so much better since I re-geared the transmission on it. Yeah. They're stock size. I don't care nothing about the big tires. It puts too much of a bind on them. Yeah, I've done re-geared this one a couple times to compensate for just those tires. Used to, it wouldn't. You see it power wheeling when I was doing a water wheelie?
Yeah.
Used to, the belt would upshift so fast, it would settle back down. Now it stays locked in a low gear on the belt, so it keeps riding the wheelie. If I had to let out of it over a couple times, it would come on back.
Yeah, I've seen it.
That's what I've been wanting with it, so I'm going to leave it alone. I like it right there. This is set up for some rock crawling right here. Yeah, you bottom out on this stuff in here, and I ain't got nothing but plastic skid plates. Just wheelie right here, boys. It's pretty stout with that gearing. Huh? I don't think this one do no donut in these tires. I mean, dang, it will. Put this thing in low and try it. If y'all got a King Quad 500, I'm fixing to do the same thing to that 750 there, my cousin Michael's. This one has an EPI natural colored spring, factory rollers, drilled to 16 grams, weighed them on a gram machine, like I was saying earlier, 1.5 millimeter shims. Best setup I've had on it yet. You can see it's got plenty of power to turn the tires, donuts, whatever. Ain't a bad little riding park. Pretty good, actually. Takes a lot of mud here, though. That's the thing about it. Lots of mud. But we're here to have a little fun, so. Last time I was here, you can watch some other videos. There's a pond right over where I winched a fuller out of. Having to go easy in some of these mud holes. I don't know how deep they are. This one here's got a tree or something in it. Got to be careful on. I think it's this one. But I'm not for sure. I don't want to do is get in here and drown this spoiler out. Top of the fenders. Well, this here was an actual good little place to ride. You got it closed off for some odd reason. It was pretty neat. A lot of mud today though.